Hey YouTubers, welcome to the vlog. I had to get up early this morning and drive Ben up to Alcona to his friend's house because they're going to Canada's Wonderland for the whole day. Unfortunately, I can't go. I have to finish editing the McDonald's season fry video. I have to shoot the VAT 19 video for Saturday because I emailed them and I promised them it'll be up on Saturday. Excuse me. And then I have to edit also the ice cream sundaes video, have that set up and ready to go because we're probably going to the cottage Sunday. And then Monday I could possibly have another like candy video. I'm trying to get all those candy things that people have sent me over the last little while. I'm trying to get that out of the way. And then I have to possibly go up to Barrie and shoot the vegan dish as kind of a shout out to a special viewer who's got some health issues and just want to give them a shout out, make them feel good. All right, it'll just take me a few more minutes to get home. Well, it's 11 o'clock. It's time for Sam's walk. I usually try to walk him at 10:30, but I lost track of time there for a minute. So I'm trying to finish up the McDonald's video as soon as possible. I usually try to finish that up by lunchtime and then I don't have to stress myself out too much because I can upload it and do all the annotations and all that stuff that I needed to get done. Another update too is my neck. It's like all sore. I woke up this morning with a hangover without drinking. I guess I was just dehydrated from rock climbing, although I drank almost a liter of water while rock climbing, and I guess it's the injury that's making me feel, this makes me feel like I'm hungover, but it's just all crazy pain right from about the middle of my head all the way down the back of my neck to my shoulder. And it's because I put my arm on the wall like this and pushed like that, and I just did some damage. And there's something over here that's spooking Sam out. He's just, look at him. He's all skittish and scared. I'm not sure, there might be something dead in the, what do you call that, swale there, ditch. Well, let's not go here then. Let's go somewhere else, dude. Why you wanna go this way? If something's scaring you, it's beyond me, come on. A bunch of you guys asked me to, I guess, elaborate on the whole bag of milk thing. So we buy milk in 4-liter bags. So there's three bags and it's about 4 liters. We do skim milk, cut back on the fat. You can still buy milk in cartons here. So you can buy the 1 liter, the 2 liter. This isn't real milk. This is like soy milk or whatever, or rice milk. It comes in this reusable container. So you throw the bag into the container, snip the top off. These were widely used too. You just put that, it's like a razor blade inside there. You just slip it along and that cuts it off. My wife prefers to use that, and it's a magnet. You can just stick it onto something metal. I use scissors still. Some people will cut the end off both sides to stop possibly the bag from coming out, but I haven't had the bag come out of this container while the milk was in there. Supposedly, I looked it up. I can't remember when they started using bags, but it's supposed to be less impact on the environment because it uses less plastic than the big plastic 4-liter or 1 gallon jugs. They are reusable, like you can, a lot of people, we don't, but a lot of people will cut the whole top open on it and wash out the bags and then use the bags for lunches or whatever, or freezing things. Of course, you have to seal it properly with an elastic or whatever. But I just thought I'd elaborate on the whole bags of milk thing. It also said something about central to eastern Canada uses it, some places in Europe. But that's pretty much as far as I know. So let me know in the comments below if you guys might even not even see that they have bags of milk in your area, or they just don't sell them either. So just let me know in the comments below how many people still only get cartons or jugs, and how many people actually do get bags of milk, or you have that choice. Because we have a choice. We can buy, like I said, we can buy the bags, we can buy the jugs, or we can buy the cartons. This is what we've been doing for years, so that's all we do. I'm on my way up to Barrie to do another food review, go figure. This one is at a vegan restaurant. I have a very special subscriber named Joey, and she has some, there's certain things that she can't eat, and she likes watching them precariously through me, I guess you could say. And so I gave her, I sent her a private email and said thank you for watching my videos, and I'm glad my videos cheer you up and make you feel good, and I would like to do a video for you. And so she said, oh, that's sweet. And I said, I found this restaurant up in Barrie, and I'll do, you know, I gave her a bunch of choices of things that we could do. And so she wanted me to try this burger combination, and it's all vegan. So stay tuned for that one. That will come up, that will go up, or should go up on Tuesday at 7 o'clock Toronto time. I made it to downtown Barrie, and I am waiting for my food to do my food review. On the way up here, I just kind of realized it's a long weekend and it was crazy traffic. But my food should be ready any second now. I'll get my food done, my food review done, and it will be up for you guys on Tuesday. All right, guys, this is the end of the day. Sunny and I are just sitting here in the sun, aren't we, Sunny? She's not much of a, as soon as I let her go, she'll run. Still getting scratched to death. Anyway, so I did my vegan. This is kind of an aftermath of eating a vegan meal before you guys see the, just the review. I don't usually do this, but I don't feel well. I don't know what it is. I was really, really hungry, and then I ate something that I'm not used to eating, but there's nothing in there that should have harmed me, but it's made me feel like crap the rest of the day. Oh my gosh. But you'll have to check out the review if you're interested in seeing how it all went down. Anyway, guys, it's around 7 o'clock. It is absolutely beautiful out today. Ben is still at Canada's Wonderland. My wife wanted to go to a drive-in tonight, but we can't when Ben, we don't know exactly what time Ben's coming home. He said like 3 hours from now. So we can't go to the drive-in because the drive-in usually get home like 1:30, 2 o'clock in the morning, so we can't do that. Anyway, guys, I hope you had an awesome Friday. I hope you have an amazing weekend. Of course, I'll be vlogging tomorrow and every day. Again, I'm going up to a cottage this weekend, so if I vlog, they'll be short. They'll be uploaded through my iPhone. They'll probably be like 6, 7 o'clock at night. All right. So I hope that's okay with you guys. I just don't have any Wi-Fi up there and I can't do really long vlogs or edit. All right, guys, like I said, have an amazing weekend and we'll talk to you tomorrow. Bye.